So I think it's important to set the context for where we are in the roadmap and everything that's happening at the graph and what this recent migration of these 10 subgraphs represents. So kind of setting the context, maybe I'll go to you, Martin. How should listeners think about where we're at in the evolution of the graph and how the first 10 subgraph migration fits in?
That's a great question. I think we're right in the middle of a huge process. So if we take a step back, we have to remember that the hosted service has been around for a couple of years. There's already like thousands of subgraphs deployed. And even if I recall correctly, during April, it processed over 20 billion queries. And then on a similar track, like the network launched at the end of last year, and the community did the first step, which was bootstrapping indexing supply. And now we've seen these first 10 subgraphs migrating, which seems like an obvious next step. But this includes a lot of work by indexing community, and it's building the muscle for the next thousands of subgraphs migrating. So when you have all of this, or you take all of this into account, you take this bird view, and there's so much more coming. Thousands of subgraphs are migrating soon to the network, and they will allow applications to become fully decentralized thanks to the graph network. This will change everything. Like, because it's not only how the community organizes itself that will change, because we'll see new relationships between indexers and curators, which let us remember that that includes subgraph developers. But more importantly, how people rethink the stack of applications will change. Data will be organized, indexed, and provided to anyone in a permissionless way. And that will change the way people think about data.